Yeah! the fresh meat.
Chicken meat.
What?
Chicken meat.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. national chairman of the New Patriotic Party, Chairman Stephen Ayusu Intim. Ladies and gentlemen of the press, the National Council of the New Patriotic Party, which is the second highest decision-making body of the party, met today, July 4, 2024, to consider nomination of Honorable Dr. Matthew Opoku-Prempeh by His Excellency Dr. Muhammadu Bawumia, the party's presidential candidate, as his running mate for the 2024 general election. The meeting, which ended a few minutes ago, did in fact consider the said nomination, which forms part of the constitutionally mandated processes for selecting the party's running mate as per Article 13(3) of the New Patriotic Party Constitution. For the avoidance of doubt, Article 13(3)(1) reads as follows: the party's presidential candidate shall, in consultation with the National Council, nominate the vice presidential candidate. Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I'm happy to report that after the necessary consideration, the National Council of the party unanimously endorsed the presidential candidate's nomination of Honorable Dr. Matthew Opoku-Prempeh, Member of Parliament for Menchia South and Energy Minister, as the Vice Presidential Candidate of the New Patriotic Party, pursuant to our Constitution, Article 13(3). This significant milestone marks the completion of the party's presidential ticket for the 2024 general election, and therefore sets the stage for the party to fully engage the Ghanaian electorate comprehensively with our message of transformation. I wish to, at this juncture, say something little about our vice presidential candidate, focusing primarily on what he brings to the New Patriotic presidential ticket, since he's not a stranger to the body politics of our country. Honorable Dr. Matthew Opoku-Prempeh is a 56-year-old medical doctor, a devoted Christian, and a consummate politician. A product of Prempeh College and the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology, both in Kumasi, as well as the Erasmus University in the Netherlands. Dr. Matthew Opoku-Prempeh, as I indicated, he is a medical doctor by training. It was at KN University that he made his first appearance as a leader after he won the position as the local National Union of Ghanaian Students, NUCS, president, a position he held from 1991 to 1992. After working with the National Health Service in the United Kingdom for some time, he returned to Ghana in 2005 to pursue a career in business and, more importantly, in politics. He successfully became the Member of Parliament for Menchia in 2009. Ahead of the 2012 elections, the constituency, as you all know, was divided into two, Menchia North and Menchia South. He again won to become the Member of Parliament in Menchia South in 2012 elections, and he retained that seat in 2016. Owing to his passion for education, His Excellency our President Nana Dankwa Akufo-Addo appointed him as Minister of Education during his first term. As Education Minister, Dr. Matthew Opoku-Prempeh, NAPO, as we popularly call him, spearheaded the implementation of the famous Free Senior High School policy. under Dr. Prempeh, the successful implementation of the government's flagship free senior high school policy saw the country's SHS population leap from 800,000 in 2016 to 1.2 million by January 2021. Ladies and gentlemen of the press, it is instructive to note that NAPO ensured that this policy was rolled out within the first year of the Akufo-Addo government when he was appointed as education minister. He didn't ask for honeymoon. I repeat, he didn't ask for honeymoon. It will be recalled that at that time, he announced that he was going to implement the free senior high school policy. Many people, including some from the civil society organization, and even some members of our government, thought it was too early for us to implement the free senior high school. But typically of NAPO, he will have none of that. He showed boldness and decisiveness when it matters most and went on with the policy, which is by far the biggest social intervention in the nation's education sector since independence. Today, posterity has vindicated him. Ghana certainly needs leaders who are bold and decisive, because it is the only way we can achieve results. It is also worthy to note that throughout his four-year tenure as Minister for Education, there was significant industrial harmony and stability in the educational front. He ensured that the concerns of teachers and other players in the education sector were adequately attended to. This therefore confirms that Dr. Matthew Opoku-Prempeh has an incredible interpersonal and negotiation skills. He's arguably the only Minister of Education in this Fourth Republic to have achieved this feat. Having delivered at the Ministry for Education, the President appointed him during his second term to head the Ministry of Energy, where again, he demonstrated his stellar leadership qualities. He worked very hard to keep our lights on. Even during times of unprecedented global economic crisis, when every sector of our economy was virtually in darkness, grasping for breath. We however concede that in the last couple of weeks and months, some part of the country did face some power challenges. But the good news is that, unlike in the past, particularly under His Excellency Dramani Mahama, where he slept in darkness for over 4 years, Dr. Matthew Opoku-Prempeh ensured that the recent power challenges we experienced did not last beyond 3 months. It's indeed result-oriented, and there's absolutely no debate about that. In recognition of his leadership skills, his contribution towards education in Ghana, particularly in respect of his role that he has played in the government flagship program, the Free Senior High School, Dr. Matthew Opoku-Prempeh, we are not surprised that he has been honored by the University of Education in Ibadan, the University of Cape Coast, the University of Professional Studies Accra, the conferment on him with honorary doctorate degrees. In July 2021, he was invited to join the Mission 4-7 High Level Advisory Group, a joint initiative for UNESCO, the Sustainable Development Solution Network for Global Citizens, and the Center for Sustainable Development at Columbia University. In conclusion, ladies and gentlemen, if you were to ask me what Dr. Matthew Opoku-Prempeh brings to the NPP presidential ticket, I would say it brings to us a bold, confident, hard-working, result-driven, decisive, grassroots mobilizer, charismatic, patriotic, and demonstrable, incorruptible person. That simplifies who Dr. Matthew Opoku-Prempeh is. In fact, he's a leader with a clear track record of achievement, and he shares Dr. Muhammadu Bawumia's vision of bold solution for our country that are responsive to the needs, opportunities, and challenges of the 21st century. In this respect, he compliments our flag bearer in many significant ways, and the two enjoy a warm personal relationship anchored in deep mutual respect. More importantly, ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Maito Opoku-Prempeh has a great working relationship with our presidential candidate, His Excellency Dr. Alhaji Muhammadu Bawumia. The synergy between these two great leaders on our presidential ticket, coupled with their proven track record and transformational campaign message, will help the new Patriotic Party to secure a resounding third conservative electoral victory on December 7, 2024. Inshallah, by the grace of God, it is possible and we will achieve it. Thank you very much, and God bless us all.
What is Dr. Opoku-Prempeh bringing to the NPP party ticket?
First of all, I think that this is a day that the Lord has made. The energy minister welcomes this very pleasant news, because I think it is an opportunity for him to once again serve. I mean, his philosophies remain service and leadership. And so it is a welcoming news, and it's also a testament to the decision-making prowess of our 2024 presidential candidate, His Excellency Alhaji Dr. Mahmoud Bawumia. Now, specifically to your question, I think that Dr. Maito Opoku-Prempeh has demonstrated in public service that he's an achiever. He's a very result-oriented individual. And so at any point in time, he has proven that anything that you give to him or you put him in charge, he's able to deliver. And so I believe that it is on the back of this that the presidential candidate has found him worthy to support him on this presidential ticket to prosecute a very formidable campaign, so that the NPP annexes the next election in a very convincing manner.
Were you kind of nervous when rumors came out that he has been nominated or selected by the presidential candidate?
Personally, not at all, because I know my boss. I know what he's made up of. I believe that the very foundation of his life has been public service. He comes from a background where public service is considered a duty. And so I think that naturally he had prepared himself for this day, and I have no doubt that given the opportunity, he was going to excel. And so today is a great day, and we look forward to my boss supporting Dr. Bawumia prosecute a very formidable campaign.
What is going to be the approach of your campaign? And we hear that the unveiling will be done next Tuesday, and then the campaign was how is it going to be for him?
I think that naturally it is going to happen. The unveiling, as you said, is going to be done definitely on Tuesday, and at the end of the day, I don't think you expect me to put our strategies out there, but definitely we're going to prosecute a very formidable campaign.
I know a lot of candidates were interested in the position, and once they were not selected, obviously there may be some sentiments towards the entire campaign process. What is your outfit doing to make sure that they rope in the other people who were hoping to be selected but were not considered?
From day one, I think the constitution of the New Patriotic Party is very clear. The decision is with the flag bearer in consultation with the National Council. And so I believe that, I mean, to the extent that it wasn't an election and it was solely the powers of the flag bearer, I mean, those people will definitely understand that the flag bearer has made his choice. And so we will all come together and then prosecute a very formidable campaign.
All right, thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
So, baby.
Congratulations.
Thank you, bro.
Thank you. I'm happy.
Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and click on the bell for more updates.